Welcome to Mr. Criminology, where we share for you to learn and succeed. In this video, we will be discussing Article 293 or Who are Guilty of Robbery? Who are guilty of robbery? Under Article 293, any person who, with intent to gain, shall take any personal property belonging to another by means of violence or intimidation of any person, or using force upon anything, shall be guilty of robbery. So siya po ang liable ng robbery. Pero ano nga ba ang robbery? Robbery, it is the taking of personal property belonging to another with intent to gain by means of violence against or intimidation of any person or using force upon anything. Para makonsider siyang robbery, may apat na elements or requirements na dapat present. First, there is personal property belonging to another. Second, there is unlawful taking of that property. Third, taking must be with intent to gain. And fourth, there is violence against or intimidation of any person or force upon things. I-discuss natin isa-isa. First, there is personal property belonging to another. Ano nga ba ang personal property? It means such property, whether tangibles or those with physical appearance and form, or intangibles, as long as they may be subject of appropriation and may be carried away without altering its nature. Example dito ay mga furniture and fixtures, appliances, etc. Ang real property naman usually yung mga nakafix sa isang lugar at hindi pwedeng ilipat. Example, building and land. So sa robbery, dapat personal property ang ninakaw. Kung real property, possible crime is not robbery but usurpation. Yung personal property na yon ay pagmamay-ari ng iba. The identity of the real owner is not necessary, so long as the personal property taken does not belong to the accused. Hence, there is no robbery or theft of one's own property. The offenses are either grave coercion instead of robbery and impossible crime of theft instead of the ordinary crime of theft. Second, there is unlawful taking of that property. Unlawful taking, it means appropriating a thing belonging to another and placing it under one's control and possession. Ito yung act na kukunin mo sa iba yung personal property nila. Third, taking must be with intent to gain. Ito yung tinatawag nating animus lucrandi. Ang pagkuha ay dapat may intent to gain, either gusto mong gamitin or para ibenta. Example, nagnakaw ka ng relo, either ang intention mo ay para gamitin ito or pagkakitaan. Pag walang intent to gain, pero gumamit ka ng dahas para makuha yung property ng iba, ang pwedeng liability ay coercion, but not robbery. Fourth, there is violence against or intimidation of any person or force upon things. Itong pang-apat ay dalawang classification ng robbery. Robbery with violence against or intimidation of persons at robbery by the use of force upon things. I-discuss natin itong dalawa in detail sa mga susunod na articles. Pag wala ni isa dyan ang present, pwedeng ang liability ni offender ay theft at hindi robbery. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to share it and to subscribe.